Simama Imara. And we had the good fortune of having the conductor come visit us, and he's from Kenya, like Kenya, Africa, it's pretty cool. His name is Evans Obanda Ndinji, and these guys have not had this piece very long. We wanted to make sure that we learned a little bit of it before he came and worked with us and kind of gave us some ideas and also some background about this piece. But as Evans would say, he's a Christian. Where he lives in Kenya, it's a prominent religion, and a lot of the pieces that they have are church songs, but yet they're in unison, and they're not made for choirs. His journey, or I guess his job and his, I guess, conviction is to create choral music with those pieces that he's grown up with and then share it with the rest of the world. And so he had the good fortune of coming over from a program to go to the ACDA retreat up, not retreat, it's not a retreat, conference, thank you, up in Portland a couple weeks ago and work with conductors there and share his music. And while he was here in the Northwest, he came and visited us and worked with Choral Edition. So we've got Caitlin Cooper, who is doing our call. And this is not one of those pieces that there's a lot of movement. I mean, technically, I mean, they would be swaying and moving a little bit, but it's definitely more of a solemn piece and a piece of just reflecting on God's goodness and his character. And so this is Sibama Imara.
Sing, mama, sing, mama, sing, mama, sing, mama.
hobby called Ave Verum Corpus, and it is going to be conducted by a senior, Isaac Melendez. last piece she's going to play at a concert this year for us, and hopefully we'll get her next year. But she's been amazing, and so thank you. Thank you, thank you for everything. Okay, this piece, if I had to choose, you know, every director I think has their top 10 choir pieces over the years that they kind of pick and choose. This one by far is in that category. It is one of the toughest pieces I've ever done with a group, but it's also one of the most amazing pieces because it reflects the complete transformation of the story of Saul, who eventually becomes Paul, and I'm not gonna get all preachy or anything, but it's just incredible what D. Randall Stroop is able to do with music.